So, we just finished watching Profit and Lace, and, well, Matt, how'd you feel about the episode?
Still not clean!
Let's get on with the show. We begin the episode with Quark giving one of his new waitresses an evaluation. He's very impressed with her performances of late. He's showing himself to be a kind, courteous, respectful boss. Then he demands sex from her.
But I'm always nice to you.
I think you could be nicer.
You mean, like, butt stuff nice?
Let's face it. The customers, the Davo girls, the Ferengi waiters, they didn't hire you. And, they can't fire you.
What's really sad is that this is actually in character for Quark.
When did you start to have trouble with Quark?
About 5 minutes after I got off the ship.
He immediately made sexual advances.
He said it was part of the job.
You wouldn't. Would you?
Sexual blackmail!
Now with wacky bassoon music! Oh, come on, guys. Everything's funnier with bassoons.
No, it really isn't. Rom interrupts a potential sexual assault to say that communications with Ferenginar are not working. The entire planet is shut off.
A Dominion invasion of Ferenginar?
And nothing of value was lost.
We finally learn why as the cast justify their paychecks for the week.
Captain, a Ferengi ship is approaching the station requesting permission to dock.
Zek and Ishka arrive. Okay, who are Zek and Ishka, in case you don't know? Zek is the Grand Negus, which is the high CEO Grand Poobah of the Ferengi. Ishka is Rom and Quark's mother, and as well as Zek's girlfriend and secret puppet ruler. Because Zek is losing his mind from old age. You're now caught up.
I was so worried.
You're a good son.
I was worried too.
And you're a good liar.
And because Ishka has convinced him to give women equality and the right to wear clothes, more on that later.
The moment fully clothed females started appearing on the streets of Ferenginar, financial chaos erupted all over the planet.
That explains the communications blackout.
He has now been deposed.
They make up 53.5% of the population and contribute virtually nothing to gross planetary income. I say it's time they started pulling their own weight.
I think it's pretty idiotic that a society wouldn't have thought of this before, especially one based on commerce!
And now Brunt is the Grand Negus.
Acting Grand Negus, Brunt.
Okay, that's not a bad line. Let's not abuse it or anything.
Well, you knew it had to be either Brunt, Lek, Gala, or Nog. They're the only other Ferengi we got left. I mean, whenever we have a Ferengi-based story, you know they're back in the writer's room going, oh, spin the wheel!
Brunt officially becomes Grand Negus in only 3 days, so it's a race to get enough influence to fight his claim.
What lovely quarters you have, Quark. Small, but lovely.
Yes, yes, you're political exiles begging a living off your son, but please, bitch about the accommodations, why don't you? Really making me like you. Zek's plan is to show Ishka off to all the businessmen to show how canny a female can be. And I will admit, she's a horrible shrew I can't stand, but she is good with finances, this has been established.
The fact that she's a terrible person theoretically shouldn't reflect on her cause, but practically, you can't help but having it do so.
And three... What was three again, my dear?
The FCA commissioners reinstate you as Negus.
Oh yeah, Zek is completely mentally feeble. Please, restore him to the height of the greatest financial empire in all of Star Trek.
And this is my wife, Lita.
I've heard so much about you.
Would you like to hear more?
Remember, she's Rom's wife.
Meaning what?
Meaning she's broke.
Otherwise, go get you some.
So Quark, Rom, and Nog call up all the businessmen that owe Zek favors and try to convince him to come visit Ishka. One agrees.
One out of 400 and change.
The commissioner who's agreed to come? It's Nilva.
The chairman of Sluggo Cola.
Sluggo Cola. I'm going to take a bath, Kim. And Brunt arrives to gloat about his impending rise to power.
Would someone please tell that female to take off those clothes? It's disgusting.
Yes, that is Jeffrey Combs. I know who that is! Take that meme from last episode.
This is the future.
Over my dead body.
If that's what it takes.
Oh God, he's like Cobra Commander from the short bus.
Once an actor!
I don't suppose you're here to reminisce about the time you helped my brother and me rescue Moogie from the Dominion.
That was a good episode. So it has no place here.
Though I find it ironic that helping to rescue your mother was the first step on my road to becoming Negus.
I never should have given you your job back with the FCA.
Everybody got that?
You may liquidate us tomorrow, but right now, this is still my establishment. Now get out before I kick you out.
I'm going to make you a pauper.
Didn't you already do that to him once and he came back somehow?
I just kicked the Grand Negus out of my bar.
Acting Grand Negus.
I need to lie down.
And so Ishka comes to bitch out her son, also known as every single day of the man's life.
He wants to play Tongo. I want to have a late night snack. You want to lie here feeling sorry for yourself. We all deal with stress in different ways.
But yours is completely unacceptable.
How can you eat at a time like this?
It's simple. You put one end of the tube grub between your front teeth and you suck them right up.
You just put your lips together and blow.
Question, why does this sound so much better when she says it?
And a savage argument suddenly breaks out between mother and son, and then Ishka keels over from a heart attack.
And nothing of value was lost.
She survives, but she's in bad shape. She'll be out of commission for the rest of this episode.
All
I do know is that she keeps repeating the same phrase over and over. It's all Quark's fault. It's all Quark's fault.
Who cares who actually started the argument? Who cares who escalated it? Who cares who kept it going when it could have stopped? No. The one who was actually involved in the argument, he's solely to blame. You see why I can't stand her? Because the episode never lets her be wrong. That's the thing. Quark is awful, but so is Ishka, but they're only acting like Quark is awful.
Well, if you ask me, Quark, the worst thing that ever happened to the Ferengi Alliance is you.
Case in point, the only reason Quark is not backing Brunt right now is out of family loyalty and duty. And yet, all they're doing is crapping on his head because he's not doing it exactly as they want him to do it. He is being loyal to you. All he's doing is being snarky about it. That's not good enough for you. He needs to get on board and be happy. Like Rom. Well, guess what? Who wants to be like Rom?
You might find me in a charitable mood.
By the time I get through with you, you're the one who's gonna need charity.
God, it's like Cartman with his balls on a cheese grater.
Screw you guys, I'm going home!
They need a clever Ferengi female. And they don't have one because Ishka's, you know, recovering from having her heart replaced.
How pitiful.
Cut, cut. Jeffrey, stop ad-libbing. You don't get to review this episode. You're in it. What are they going to do? Well, what would TGIF do?
If she couldn't find another female,
She'd what?
She'd make one.
You mean a hologram?
Better.
Better. Faster. Dumber.
Yes. Quark is now Caitlin Quark.
How do I look?
This is what nightmares are made of, kids.